About the social role of universities in COVID crisis, the rise of knowledge.
Okay,
So let's start.
I will share the screen. Just a moment. Okay.
Here we are.
Here we are. So University of Ljubljana and its member institutions have been actively engaged in the battle against coronavirus since the very beginning. In the next minutes, you will see our efforts, which resulted in greater trust in knowledge in general. But first, some basic information about University of Ljubljana. Our university is the largest and oldest higher education, scientific research and arts institution in Slovenia, with almost 40,000 students and more than 6,000 employees. It was established in 1919 with 5 member institutions. Now there are 26, 23 faculties and 3 academies. The University of Ljubljana is an international university and basically covers all fields of study, as you can see. Within our university and in cooperation with foreign universities, we provide interdisciplinary and multidisciplinary study programs in all 3 cycles. So this was a very short introduction of our university, and now let's get to the topic. And so it came COVID-19. This is sort of a timeline of events. The epicenter of coronavirus in Europe was in northern Italy. That was in February 2020. As you can see, the dark green patch on the map is Slovenia, and northern Italy left from the patch is just right next to it. So of course we had cause for concern. The Ministry of Education sent the first recommendations regarding coronavirus to kindergartens, schools, universities, and research institutes. On February 25th, the University of Ljubljana called on students and employees who have been staying in northern Italian cities for the past 10 days to stay home. On March 8th, the University of Ljubljana member canceled lectures in large classrooms where 100 or more people can gather for at least 14 days and replace them by other forms of lectures. On March 11th, all the forms of direct classes is canceled and all personal contacts limited in all other activities. So we basically started working from home. On March 12th, the epidemic in Slovenia was declared, and on May 15th, the epidemic was called off. Some restrictions were still on and most of us were still working from home and the lectures were held online. So how did we deal with the crisis? We, and I am sure all the universities as well, took the situation very seriously. On university's website, we opened the tab UL and coronavirus, where we were constantly putting information about the coronavirus situation at the University of Ljubljana. The tab held and still holds ongoing publications of rector's resolutions and constant news regarding operation of University of Ljubljana during epidemic time. Rector's resolutions were mainly made in accordance with the proposal of the COVID-19 coordination team at University of Ljubljana based on opinions of epidemiologists and infectologists. And when we opened the tab, we immediately published the rector's message. This way we gained trust from students and employees about the situation. We knew we had to take care of them, stay active and keep up to date. Employees and students were informed about what was happening at our university during the epidemic through internal e-newsletters. We collected online events, advice, recommendations, and offers from our members and the professional services of the rectorate, which helped us getting through the hard times easier and safer. And we also showed that life at our university continued and that we were always active. Online events and webinars were open to public because we also knew we had to take care of the community. Not only with online events, but also with other activities, which soon made us a key player in resolving the coronavirus crisis in Slovenian society. Now here is the example of the first newsletter. It's called E-Univerzitetnik. the design, the graphic shows a coronavirus cut in half. As you can see, this is a regular newsletter, but its importance was shown even more during a lockdown. It's prepared by the rectorate and contains mainly corporate news. It is published every other month and sent to all employees of the university and student council. It always starts, of course, with a foreword, and here it says, with a strong will, we can do anything. And then foreword is followed with different articles. This is the other example. Oh, sorry. I have to go. Oh, here is the other example. This is called 3+23, is the number of our members, 3 academies and 23 faculties. And it is written in cooperation with the members, sent to all employees again and student council, and is also published periodically every other month. So if you're interested, the forward here says, the future is not clear, but we are better prepared for it. Here are some online events and webinars that we shared with the public, and they were very well accepted. The list, of course, goes on, but I just wanted to point out a few. So I will not read them all. You can see them here. Then here are advice and recommendations. They were constantly posted on our website and websites of our faculties and academies, and some topics are listed here. So you can see, I won't read them, so. But what really made us important in our country, or even more important, during the epidemic were the following activities. Around 70 senior students from Faculty of Medicine were working at the government call center, supervised and mentored by medical professionals and the representatives of various ministries. Students from Faculty of Medicine and Faculty of Health Science, 80 altogether, responded to the Slovenian Red Cross requests for voluntary assistance and performing the tasks and activities in its patient treatment unit operating at the field hospital. Faculty of Mechanical Engineering helped families who didn't have appropriate technical equipment for studying at home. Basically, the faculty joined the initiative of several Slovenian companies and institutions to donate computer equipment to school children and their parents. The Institute of Microbiology and Immunology at the Faculty of Medicine still performs laboratory diagnostics tests for COVID-19. In the care of patients' health and well-being, a working group at the Faculty of Pharmacy has been set up to keep up with the latest developments in COVID-19 therapy and the development of antiviral medicines. Nursing students at the Faculty of Health Science responded to the invitation of the Nurses and Midwives Association of Slovenia and the Nursing and Midwifery Student Section and offered voluntary assistance to their professional colleagues at retirement homes. Their decision to help out is not only about saying, yes, I'll go and help. It is much more than that. The students had to leave their families and expose themselves to a high risk of infection. Now, due to potential lack of ventilators, Slovenian researchers were asked to develop emergency prototypes. Fespirator was developed by the Faculty of Electrical Engineering. Fespirator, well, F is for faculty and E is for electrical engineering, so we know, exceeds the level of the breathing device and approaches professional ventilators. So the device is now ready to save lives in case of a pandemic emergency. Veterinary faculty published recommendations for animal owners and set up a special email for questions regarding coronavirus. The faculty is monitoring all information regarding the possible role animals play in transmitting the coronavirus. And they also started animal testing for the presence of the virus. The list of volunteers who sew protective masks for charity was getting longer. Faculty of Natural Sciences and Engineering prepared instructions for sewing reusable cotton masks and joined the volunteers who sew protective masks for charity along with the students and alumni of the faculty. Students of Academy of Fine Arts and Design responded to open call for designing a coronavirus city posters. The aim of the campaign was to inspire responsibility and humanity in individuals in the battle against the epidemic. In May, Slovenia has successfully carried out a nationwide survey on the prevalence of the new coronavirus in the population with the assistance of three universities of Ljubljana faculties. This is one of the first surveys of this type conducted in the world. The key role was played by the Faculty of Medicine, the Faculty of Computer and Information Science, and Faculty of Social Sciences. The survey showed that with 95% certainty that 2 to 4% of Slovenian population has been infected with the coronavirus. So that was in May. Now I will show you the testing of Faspirator. Now you can see the picture here. And here are the examples of coronavirus CT posters made by our students. Now, and what is also important is the contribution of University of Ljubljana researchers to fight against COVID-19. The Slovenian Research Agency has compiled an overview of research work that can contribute directly or indirectly to greater success in combating the COVID-19 pandemic. The agency asked the heads of research programs and projects to report on the extent and manner in which their research is relevant in preventing the spread of the COVID-19 pandemic, treating the sick, and improving the responsiveness and capacities of the healthcare system. I put a link down below. Put the link down below of research programs and projects being conducted by researchers at the University of Ljubljana that might directly or indirectly combat the COVID-19 pandemic. Okay. So that's it. Close this. Here. So, in conclusion, the University of Ljubljana has taken the coronavirus situation very seriously. Besides regular informing about the coronavirus situation, we try to keep our work processes running to the greater extent possible. And as a university, we were always working to ensure the well-being of our society. Many University of Ljubljana member institutions have come to the aid of Slovenian citizens. And our citizens have noticed that the role of universities is important, that knowledge is a value, that science and research are crucial for the development of our society, and that the public sector is actually not meaningless and self-serving. And we quite clearly prove them wrong. Thank you.
Darja, thank you so much. The role of university in resolving crisis is tremendous, you know?
It's, yeah.